point.
Now, rebuke
this,
them in the name of the Lord. Ask him to destroy their technology.
Mm-hmm.
Because if it's a military attack against you, ask them to break their equipment.
Uh-huh.
If it's a spiritual attack against you, just rebuke them in the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
Command them to leave.
Uh-huh.
I'm not sure what's going on. Like I said, I've heard about it from quite a few people lately.
Would it have to do with possibly implants in one's body?
No, I have a feeling, well, you know what, everybody's implanted. If you've had vaccinations since you were a baby, you're implanted.
Well, actually, I had this experience when I was younger. Actually, my parents just told me about it not too long ago, and they had withheld it for, you know, since my childhood. And there was this one occasion where they had woken up at 4 o'clock in the morning to the doorbell ringing, and there I was standing outside, disoriented, not sure of what happened, just trying to get in. This is before I could get in or out of my house, and they had just told me about this. And one time when I was young, I just woke up, and I remember this scar just appearing on my hand out of nowhere. It's on my right hand, on my index finger. And ever since, I've been, you know, following the Lord and looking into things closely and trying to find the truth. And ever since he's led me to your site, he's just revealed to me that, you know, this possibly, you know, was an implant in my hand. And I just feel like everything's just adding up, and it's just, you know, this could be, you know, something.
Well, I have on the site, you can go, and I have those, my one page on detecting chip implants.
Right.
Where you can use neodyme magnets to deactivate them.
Yeah, you know, and I ordered some of those 2 weeks ago, and they arrived today.
Get a compass.
I'm not exactly sure, like, what I'm supposed to do with those magnets exactly. Am I just supposed to tape them to my...
Yeah, use a Band-Aid or tape and tape them. You want the north side on the skin.
Okay.
So get, like, go get a toy compass, $2 or $3 compass at the hardware store or something, and point it on the magnet. It'll tell you what the north side is, the south side of the magnet is.
Mm-hmm.
And you want the north side against the skin.
Okay.
And so put it where you think you have a chip implant.
Uh-huh.
And just leave it there. Usually if it's close to the surface, like a finger, about 12 hours.
Okay.
Just leave it on there.
Protruding out of my skin, that's the thing, eh? And like when it happened when I was younger, or, you know, when it appeared, I was just so young, and I just thought, well, I just disregarded it after a while because I couldn't really figure out where it came from. And just now he's been revealing this to me, and it's, you know, it's pretty obvious that it looks like someone's cut into my hand and put something in there, but I have no recollection of, you know,
most people don't.
What's that?
Most people that have been implanted, they don't have to take you to a UFO ship to implant you. Most children wake up with bloody noses. Or most adults can remember waking up as children with bloody noses. They get you in your bed.
Mm-hmm.
And you have no recollection, no memory of it.
Yeah, well, apparently I was outside trying to get in at 4 in the morning. So
and these are tracking chips, and they've had this tracking program going on for years where they've tried to track just about every human imaginable. Well, that's why they get you when you're a child.
Yeah.
So by the time they're adults, they already have them implanted.
Mm-hmm.
And they're tracking and control chips. And now our military has this technology.
Uh-huh. So these are alien implants, you think?
Well, right now they're both.
They're
because
both.
Our military
and
has the same technology.
And so they're
using them for their own purposes so that they can torture people with their ELF technology.
Yeah.
That have these implants.
Yeah.
You don't even have to have these implants to be tortured by ELF, but there's other types of technology that they have, like psychotronic warfare and stuff, to work against people that do have implants, and ELF does work against people with implants. But it's all just an endless mirage of agendas, all designed to torment, persecute people, track and control them, speak to them and tell them they're God. You see these women killing their children because God told them to.
Yeah.
The masquerade is a lot of things. People talk about hearing voices in their head, and that's this whole technology phenomenon. They're not crazy.
I remember at one point when I was younger, there was this shift in my mentality, and it must have been around the time that this happened, but I just, you know, it felt like I lost my spirit, and just I'd have all these, like, evil thoughts, and they just come out of nowhere, and they, you know, oppressed me up until the point, you know, where I met the Lord, and then he slowly started to change my mentality, and these spirits, I guess, or whatever, they were cast out of me, and just, you know, he's just been guiding me along, and now he's just showing me that, I think this is the root of the problem. He's showing me that there's, you know, there's a method to everything that's going on.
Yeah.
With this, you know, new world order agenda and whatnot, and these chips and these technologies, these ELF technologies are definitely, you know, what I believe.
Yeah, well, they're trying to control and influence the way people think.
Yeah.
and to you know, make them a massive, just a herd of sheep,
yeah,
to go along and accept the New World Order, and to,
yeah,
keep them as passive as possible,
mm-hmm,
make them lethargic to where you can't even stand up and fight for your own country or voice an opinion against them.
Yeah.
You know, lethargy, being lethargic was one of the biggest results from that, this whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
Keeping people lethargic, keeping them ducked down.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's just one agenda after the next, and what you can do to fight it is just getting these magnets, deactivating chips, and just using the name of the Lord to fight against it all.
Yeah. I also purchased some of that orgone, the stuff that Anne, I guess, is distributing.
Yeah, orgone will help.
Yeah.
Orgone will keep a lot of the attacks in your bedroom at night from stopping. Some people put it underneath their beds.
Uh-huh.
That way it can't be bothered with or messed with. It's still always there.
Mm-hmm. So it should notice a difference, you think, with the
Oh, yeah, thing? Definitely. You put some orgone underneath your bed, you'll,
okay,
sleep like a baby.
Okay.
Yeah, definite difference.
I have a lot of, like, I read on your site about these deep towers that are going up in the States. I'm not sure, like, about what's happening here in Canada. I don't think you cover a lot of stuff on that, but there is a lot of towers downtown around the area that I live in, and a lot of...
Oh, Canada's just a mirror of the United States. What's going,
yeah,
on here is going on there, and vice versa.
Uh-huh.
It's just a mirror. Both countries are pretty much... Canada's probably ahead of us right now.
Yeah, they're assimilating slowly, but...
Yeah, I mean, and it'll work the same. Got a lot of people in Canada making orgone and getting it everywhere out there.
Really?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah, I couldn't find anything in Canada. There's not, like, I don't really know of any websites that have anything to do with things on this magnitude in Canada. I haven't found anything, anyways.
Yeah.
I find your site to be the most informative, definitely, by far.
Yeah. Well, you can get it on the directions on my site, how to make it.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I know there's a lot of people out in Canada that are doing it, but you know what? It's like the United States. You could possibly never have enough people to cover everything that needs covered.
Mm-hmm.
But you can do what you can.
Mm-hmm.
Protect yourself, protect your own neighborhood, protect your own family,
mm-hmm,
and move from there and get in whole,
right,
areas. You know, because this is one definite kink in their whole plan, the New World Order agenda.
Right.
You know, I see it all the time in the codes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that orgone is just totally devastates them. It's a huge kink in their plans.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what motivates me to keep going with it, keep going, because the more you see how much it hurts them.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we don't see it right now, but we will later.
Right. Yeah, so I have two of those pendants. Do you think I should invest in more in making as much as I can? I guess that would probably be the best idea. Eh?
Oh, yeah, that way you're always got one with you. You're always protected.
Right.
So anywhere you go out of an area that isn't protected with orgone, you're still protected yourself.
Mm-hmm. Hello? Hello?
You still there, Sherry? I'm going to have to let you go, caller. Looks like
Hello?
We lost our host.